afternoon, everyone. Back up here at the plot again. First dry day we've had all week. And I've just had a look at my raised bed. And we've got a bit of a disaster here. The slugs have really come out this week. And there's hardly anything left. Come on over and I'll show you what I mean. These were my pak choi, and as you can see, everyone's been stripped back. This is my spinach, perpetual spinach, and they've all been taken back. There should be, oh, there's one there. That's a little beetroot, and that's bindweed and bindweed. So about the only thing they haven't eaten is the bindweed. This is little gem lettuce. Now some of the Swiss chard has fared a little bit better, but even there I've got some damage. And there should be radishes in there, but I can't see any. There was some, I can't see any now. And that's more bindweed growing there and there. So all the good stuff that I've put in seems to have been munched, and all the bindweed hasn't been touched. This little potato's perked up a bit. That's looking a lot healthier, and the peas are looking quite good. But yeah, we've had strong winds and rain all week, so the plot could do with a haircut. But first, I think it's time to get heavy-handed with the slugs. Well, I've been onto eBay and I've bought myself 12 slug traps. 14 quid for a 12. They're not the most robust plastics, but we'll give them a try and see what happens. So you fill up to the line with beer, and it should attract the snails and slugs. I've been to the local supermarket and I bought 4 cans of the cheapest beer I could find. Depot number 90, 2% proof lager, light and refreshing. Well, let's hope the slugs find it light and refreshing. So, yeah, 125 for 4 cans of this week beer. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start putting some of these beer traps all around the plot. So, yeah, I'm going to crack on with that and I'll show you what it's like when I'm finished. Well, I've put traps on most of the beds. Having a look around, there's lots of damage. I think I made a mistake with mulching the rhubarb bed because it's just become a hiding place for slugs. So I've put a pot in there as well. So let's get some depot number 90 in here. And there you go. Cheers, Mr. Slug. I hate wasting good beer, but I don't think this is good beer, so I'm not too bothered. Now, I also got one of these with the traps. I'm not actually sure where it is, but I'm supposed to put a few drops in. So I'll see if I can get that. Okay, I don't know what that is. It's, the traps are supposed to be non-toxic, so I don't think it's a poison. I'm not quite sure. I think it's something to attract, something else to attract the slugs to the beer. But all I have to do now is to put a lid on. I might actually put something on top of that, stone or something, just to ensure that it doesn't come off. And I've just got to go round and do all the other bits now. Well, I've just emptied all the beer traps and it has been a worthwhile exercise. I reckon I've captured about 200 slugs. A lot of them are small ones, but these small ones will grow big in time, especially the way they're eating through everything that's green on the allotment. So for the price of 4 cans of cheap beer, £1.25, yeah, I think it's been a worthwhile test, and I'm just kicking myself I haven't bought any more beer to bring up to fill up the traps again, but there's still some beer still left in the traps, so we'll leave them like that and see if we collect any more. But I'm now just going to go and get rid of all these dead slugs, probably over the perimeter wall. Okay, so this is the Nema slug, biological slug killer. It's organic, and we just add water. This should treat up to 100 metres. And this plot's a lot bigger than 100 metres, but not all of it is getting cultivated on. It's like a wilderness, it's up in that corner at the minute. So what you do with this, it's like a powder. And you mix this with 10 litres of water to create a stock solution. Now you stir that, then use half a litre of a stock solution to 5 litres of water. Then you water that into the ground. Then keep going until the whole ground's filled, or the whole ground's treated, or you've run out of nematodes. Comfortable. 20 watering cans of 5 litres. So we'll get that done tonight. Some areas might take more. I was surprised the other night, the area with the salad leaves on it, there was very few slugs in the beer traps, whereas the area where the onions were, they had the most slugs. So, I'm going to give this a go. I'll show you what it looks like. It just looks like a powder. So the nematodes are microscopic and they're all mixed in with this powder, and we'll mix that in. So we'll do that now and we'll get the stock solution and we'll fill up the watering cans and start treating the area. So I've got half a litre of the stock solution in here, which is going to go in there. Then I need 5 litres of water. I've not got a measuring jug, so I'm just going to use this old 1 litre milk carton. So that's gone.